With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello students, the question given here is that we measure the period of oscillation of a simple pendulum. In successive measurements, the readings turn out to the 2.63 second, 2.56 second, 2.42 seconds, 2.71 second and 2.80 seconds. Option A says the absolute errors in the measurement are 0.01 second, 0.06 second, 0.20 second, 0.20 second and 0.09 and 0.18 second. Whereas B says the mean absolute error is this 0.11 second. The mean time period can be reported as this. Okay. And option D says the time period can actually be reported as this second with a percentage error of 4%. Okay, so let us check how many options are correct over here. Okay. So first we have to find the absolute error in the measurements. Okay. So let us find the absolute errors in the measurement. So before that we have to find the mean. Okay. So the mean period of oscillation of pendulum is the mean period of oscillation of pendulum. Okay. The mean period of oscillations of pendulum is. Okay. So first we have to find the mean of them. So let us find the mean. We can find the mean as T is equal to sum of all the observation and the number of observation. Okay. Sum is 2.63, 2.56, 2.42. So let us write down 2.63 plus 2.56 plus 2.42. 2.71 plus 2.80, these are seconds, divide by the number of observation. Okay, so let us divide them by number of observation. Divide them by number of observation, that is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so on solving this we get it is equal to 13.22 second divide by 5. That is equal to 2.624 seconds. That is equal to 2.62 seconds. Okay, this is what we get as the mean. Now we have to find the absolute errors. So let us find the absolute errors over here. Okay, so absolute errors can be found as absolute errors. So absolute error, that means the initial value and the value as mean. Okay. So 2.63 minus 2.62, that is equal to 0.01 second. 2.56 minus 2.62, that is equal to minus of 0.06 second. Okay. And then again 2.42. minus of 2.62 seconds, that is equal to minus of 0.20 second. Another 2.71 minus 2.62, that is equal to 0.09 second. Okay, and another last one is 2.80 minus 2.62 second, that is equal to 0.18 second. Right, so these are the absolute errors, and the absolute errors are found in the mod. Okay, so we will write them as modulus of 0.01 second and modulus of 0.06 second, modulus of 0.20 second and 0.09 second, 0.18 second. Okay, so these values come in the form mod, so we will write them like this. So the absolute errors are, or we can say according to question, the absolute errors in the measurements are, as you can see, 0.01 second, 0.06 second, 0.20 second and 0.01 and 0.18. so this is correct answer. This option is correct because the absolute errors are like this. Okay, the absolute errors are like this. So absolute errors are, so we can say as the option number one, that absolute errors are, okay, 0.01 second, 0.06 second, 0.20 seconds, 0.09 seconds, and 0.18 second. Okay, now in option number B, the mean absolute error is 0.011 second. We have to find this. And let us check if it matches. Okay, so we have to find the mean absolute error. Okay, so for option number B, mean absolute error. Okay, so let us find the mean absolute error. We can find it as delta t mean. Okay, so delta t mean can be find as, we will add them 0.01 plus 0.06 plus 0.20 plus 0.09 plus 0.18 and divide it by the number of observations, that is 5. Okay, so on solving it, we will get 0.54 second by 5. Okay, that is approximately equal to 0.11 second. Okay, so the mean absolute error, as you can see, is 0.11 second. Okay, 0.11 second. Okay, so let us check our options over here. So option number B says the mean absolute error is 0.11 second. It is also correct. For option number C, let us check the mean. Then the mean time period can be reported as 0.62 plus 0.11 second. So let us check the mean time period. Option number C. Option number C is mean time period. Okay, so let us check for the mean time period. So the mean time period. Okay, so the mean time period. Okay, the mean time period can be reported as 0.62. Okay, 2.62 plus minus 0.11 second. Okay, that means it lies between. That means the mean time period lies between 2.62 minus 0.11 second. Okay, so it can be written as 2.73 second and 2.51 second. Okay, so it is the mean time period that it lies between these two values. Okay, so let us check our option number C. What does it say? So option number C says the mean time period can be reported as this. Okay, so it is also correct. So let us check our option number D. The time period can actually be reported as 2.62 plus 0.1 second with a percentage error of 4%. Okay, so we can write the time period as, okay, so option number D. So the time period can actually be reported as, okay, can actually be reported as, sorry, the time period can actually be reported as it can be reported as 0.2.6 plus minus 0.1. Okay, it can be reported as like this also. Now it has been told that the percentage error, so let us find the percentage error. The percentage error in this time period. So the percentage error is equal to 0.1 divided by 2.6 into 100%. That is equal to, on solving it, we will get as 4%. Okay, what we will get? We will get 4% as percentage error. Okay, so let us check our option number D also. So option number D says the time period can be reported as 2.6 plus 0.11. It can be written like this also because it is the most accurate one. We will write it like this. And the percentage error, as you can see, was 4% as we have solved it. all the options 1, A, B, C, and D, all the options are correct over here. So correct options are option number A, option number B, option number C, and option number D. So all of these options are correct. Okay. So I hope you understood this question. It is clear to you now. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.